Today we are going to learn about the plumbing. The plumbing, the word comes from Latin word plumbum, that is used earlier for the lead, as pipes were once made from lead. Plumbing in the system of pipes. Plumbing is a system of pipes, drains, fittings, valves, valve assemblies and devices installed in a building for the distribution of water for drinking, heating, washing and the removal of waterborne wastes. The skilled trade of working with pipes, tubing and plumbing fixtures in the system is known as plumbing. Plumbing denotes the supply and waste system of an individual building, distinguishing it from water supply and sewage system that serve a group of buildings. Components of plumbing. There are the several components of plumbing like pipes, PEX, copper piping, PVC, galvanized pipe, brass, cast iron piping, cement pipes. And other components are pipe fittings, coupling, reducer, valves, elbows, unions, T, cross, cap, pump. Pipes. This is a pipe. You can see this is a pipe, the hollow cylinder, a hollow cylinder following certain dimension rules. There are several types of pipes. Flexible plastic piping. These pipes are flexible. So, the popular selection in industrial and small business applications is the flexible pipes. The flexible pipe is slightly higher in initial cost, minimum maintenance and fast installation process, leak-free product offering advantages over copper piping, and it cannot be used in outdoor applications as UV rays can damage its outdoor plastic layer. So there are several dimensions of flexible plastic pipes available. It ranges from 1/2 inches to 1.5 inches or more. There are copper piping. Copper piping is most often used for supply of hot and cold tap water, and it is used as refrigerant line in HVAC system, heating, ventilation and air conditioning. There are two basic types of copper tubing, soft copper and rigid copper. Soft copper pipe, soft or ductile copper tubing can be bent easily to travel around obstacles in the path of the tubing, while the work hardening of the drawing process used to size the tubing makes the copper hard or rigid. It is carefully annealed to make it soft again. It is therefore more expensive to produce than non-annealed rigid copper tubing. And most popular choice for refrigerant lines in a split air system, air conditioners and heat pumps. Rigid copper, as the name says, rigid copper is rigid in nature. It is a popular choice for water lines. It is wound using a sweat roll grooved compression or crimp or pressed connections. Rigid copper, rigid due to the work hardening of the drawing process, cannot be bent and must use elbow. This is the elbow, you can see. This is elbow. Elbow fittings to go around corners or around obstacles. If heated and allowed to slowly cool in a process called annealing, rigid copper will become soft and can be bent or formed and without cracking. There is another type of pipes, like this is the PVC pipes. This is UPVC pipes. PVC is the pipes that can be used in a grain curler. You can easily identify it is used in the households applications. PVC full name is polyvinyl chloride, and it is used for hot and cold potable water as well as sewage applications. Vary on their thickness and configuration depending on the application where to be used. There are several examples, like pressure water pipes are not the same as sewer pipes and not the same as ones used on a storm drainage systems. There are different applications like hot water and cold water applications, galvanized piping. These pipes are used several years ago, and since long it is being used, as these are less frequent use now, as rust can build up inside a small diameter pipes. If pipe is old, water coming from the faucet will rust resist can be seen. Can be used to transport grey water or non-potable water. Galvanized pipe are used for high temperature or pressure manufacturing processes, and it is also used in petroleum industries.